What's happening, people? It's Phil Free Yen here. Today I wanted to talk to you first about this DIY convertible job you can do. Basically, if you have a Ford car, even if you have a Fiesta or a Vauxhall Astro or any car really you could do this with, depending on how tough the structure is. And also, if it's got a roll cage, it's going to be more difficult. Basically, you just get an angle grinder, chop off the roof, chop off the sides, and you got a perfect convertible. I don't know if any of you guys seen the old 007 Bond movie where he goes under a bridge. They've probably done it in a lot. I think they've done it in other films as well. And the top ducks and then the top of the car's taken off and he's driving around in the car. That's what this kind of reminded me of. We don't know who owns this car because it was basically in Swindon in the UK. And the police picked the car up and towed it away because it wasn't legal, basically. I guess all the sharp edges and stuff like that probably make it a little bit more lethal. Also, the guy didn't have tax or rail insurance and stuff, so that probably made their choice to pick it up a bit more easier. Anyway, cool way to avoid this heat we've been having in the UK. And a good idea, I guess, if you don't mind getting your car taken away after a few little drives. The next thing I want to say to you guys is, have you heard this joke? Basically, a horse walks into a bar and that's it. A horse walked into a bar. Basically, in a Manchester pub, this guy rode his horse into the bar. Yeah, this guy, 58-year-old landscape gardener, dad of three from Radcliffe, actually rode this horse into the bar. He said he rode it in because this woman was saying that, he was not very good with animals or something. So he decided to ride it in to show how good he is with animals. Despite hitting his leg on the way out, it went pretty flawlessly. Horse didn't mess up, and the landlord said it was cool for him to bring it in as long as he cleaned it up if it didn't make a mess. So yeah, it's pretty funny that this guy done it. To be honest, it kills all the jokes now when you say a horse walked into the bar. Are you talking about that horse in the Radcliffe? You can kind of reply to these guys now. Yeah, the next story I want to talk about was this woman left her child in a car while she went shopping at Next. In this heat, we've had the hottest few days in the UK since, it's been crazy temperatures. And this woman locked her child in a car for 40 minutes. Like, in this heat, they can die in that sort of heat. I posted a story about the dog. I don't know if you've seen that. I think it was my last video. And the police broke the dog out of the car. This is what they had to do for this child in a shopping centre in Watford. They had to break in and take the child out to help it. But it's just, this shouldn't happen. You know what I mean? Parents, if you've got a child, don't leave it in the car in this heat. Like, my advice is to keep a child out of this heat between 11 and 3. Keep them in the shade between those times, because that's the time they're going to burn up. And then you don't want them having, heat stroke or any of the problems that heat can bring. And they're young, they don't really have the defenses to control their internal temperatures. So yeah, just be a little bit more sensible about this, because you don't want to hear a story of a child dying because someone left in the car when they went shopping for their bloody Brian Nichols in Next. And yeah, from that story to another one, I was thinking about not mentioning this story because it's horrible, but I have to. I'm not going to put the video in because it's just sick, but basically this guy bit a head of a pet cat off and killed the cat and tortured it and stuff. It's just disgusting. And yeah, it was a 22-year-old guy threw the cat against the wall and she died of injuries. It's disgusting that it happened, and they got it on film because the guy that had to film it was being accused of abusing the animal or something, and he had to film the guy to kind of prove it was the younger guy because he was a bit messed up in the head. And yeah, he filmed it to prove it wasn't him because people were giving him death threats and stuff. We're top of the food chain, and if we're going to eat an animal, then yeah, you kill it and you can eat it. But in this sense, no. You don't torture and abuse animals for your own, sake of enjoyment or whatever. That's just sick. You got to show respect to them because, you can really hurt them and stuff. And they just want to live their lives. It is horrible. Obviously, the link's in the description if you want to watch it. I suggest not bothering because it's disgusting. Maybe go to look at the guy so you can get his face in case you're in one of the wings that he's in and give him a nice little beat down. But yeah, I'm sorry to leave it on that story. It's kind of horrible. And like I said, I wasn't going to mention it because it's horrible, but I had to let people know, especially because if you see this guy or whatever, you can give him a fork, because at the end of the day, this sort of stuff shouldn't happen, really. I don't know. I go through the news every day to get new stories for the show. Sometimes the stuff I see, it just makes me question what's going on with people, what's up with their heads thinking this sort of stuff. Something they should be doing, let alone thinking it, actually bloody doing it. Madness. Anyway, I say feed them to the lions.
Feed them to the lions. Feed them to the lions. I said feed them to the lions. You tell him there's no running from me, ducking, diving from me. No God can save you from me. You tell that little shit, look, there's no running from me.
fucking diving from me. No good to save you from me. Fuck it, I straight feed him, get a lion. Feed him, get a lion. Feed him, get a lion. I said feed him, get a lion. And that's all for today. I hope you had a great day. If you're in the UK, I hope you're enjoying this heatwave we've been having. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.